This is second part of the tutorial about perforation, and in this part I will teach you how to cut upper, how to make perforation and how to sew it, so you will know the entire process. Learn how to make shoes with my step-by-step video courses. Now, before we start, let's go with the questions. One of the questions you asked me was about punchers. What is the name of the brand, where to buy? So believe me, the name of the brand doesn't important. What is important is the diameter of punchers. These punchers that I use, I bought many years ago. So I don't remember the name, but you can find these punchers in your local store, maybe online. What you need to search for is the number of the hole of the puncher. In the perforation we make in this tutorial, we need to have two different numbers of punchers. One is big one, and the maximum of the diameter for this puncher is 4.5 millimeters, and second one is the small one with a diameter of minimum is 1 millimeter. You can use also 1.5 millimeters, 2 millimeters. What is important is that must be visible difference between big hole and small one. So for example, if you use diameter like I used in this tutorial, 3.5 millimeters, so it's enough for me to use puncher with diameter of 1.5 millimeters or even 2 millimeters for the small holes, because here will be a distance between two holes 1.5 millimeters, and it's enough to see the difference between these two holes. Okay, so you can find these types of punchers where it has handle and different numbers of punchers that you can insert inside of this handle that you can open and place. There is another type of punchers like this one that comes already with the handle, and it has firm numbers, like this is diameter, the number of this puncher, the diameter of this puncher is 4 millimeters, for example, and you can find like this one with different numbers of diameters. You ask me a lot about this instrument, gauges for seam allowance. I work with this instrument a lot because I work professionally as a pattern maker, as a shoemaker, and I use them a lot. But you as a beginners don't need to use these professional tools, because first of all, they are expensive and really hard to find them right now. You can search, but it's difficult to find. So what you can use is compasses for pattern making that consists of two pins, two sharp pins. For example, in usual compasses we have one sharp pin and pencil. So for pattern making there is compasses with two pins. I don't have right now it to show you, but you can see the picture of it, and I will leave a link to this tool where you can find it. Another question you asked me was about different type of perforation. Perforation without separating your upper on two details. Actually, it's much easier. What you need to do is to mark all needed marks like we did in the previous lesson on your upper, on the place where you want to do it. For example, in the middle without the separating. So marks of two seams in the distance of 1 centimeter, and in the middle you need to mark marks for big holes. That's it. So how to perforate it you will see later in this tutorial, but you need to create extra detail that I will not show in this tutorial because I don't need it for this type of perforation, is thin strip of leather that you will need to attach to your upper on the inner side of the upper after you will make the perforation to cover these holes. Because if you will not cover these holes with same type of leather, for example, or with the leather with different color, through these holes you will see the inner part of lining, and this is not good. Okay, so this is the only difference between these two types of the perforation. Now, if I didn't answer one of your questions, you will find the answer to your questions in this tutorial, because I will explain you everything you need to know step by step from cutting till the sewing. Okay, so watch the tutorial and let's start. So now we will cut these two uppers from leather. For the upper, I choose calfskin. The thickness of leather is 1 millimeter or 1.2 millimeters. This usual thickness that we use in making women's shoes. So I choose two colors, white and beige. This is my choice. You can work with same color, of course, or choose few colors if you have more parts in your upper. Okay, what we need else? We need the knife, utility knife. It's one of the tools that we use in shoemaking, and I made few tutorials about this knife, and I will leave a link to these videos below the video. We need puncher with two diameters, silver pen to transfer all needed marks that we have on the pattern. Also, we need lighter to burn edges of leather, some hammer, another hammer, shoemaking hammer. There is a special hammer for folding, for flatting the threads, but actually you can work with a shoemaking hammer that we use in many different steps in making shoes. Okay, hammer, then we need also awl, shoemaking knife. Also, you can check the link about this knife, and I will leave it below the video. And some other piece of thick cardboard to protect your cutting board when you will punch holes, so you will not leave marks of holes on your cutting board, and that's why choose some thick cardboard, doesn't important which one. I use the cardboard from Texon, Texon that we use in making insoles. Okay, and then also you will need, of course, glue, contact glue for leather. So first thing is that we need to cut out these two parts of our upper. This one will be white color. I will use some edge of leather to cut this example. I didn't check here stretchiness because it will not be the real upper, but when you will cut your uppers, you need to check the stretchiness of leather and place your upper along direction in which leather stretches less. For example, this is how we check. You need to stretch leather in this direction and then in this direction. In this direction it stretches more than in this direction, so I should place my upper in this direction. Okay, but because it's not real upper and I don't want to waste too much leather for this part, I will place it like this, okay? Because right now it doesn't important for me because it's not real upper. So how we cut? You know, many shoemakers first of all, they transfer all lines with silver pen. I don't like it. I prefer to cut right away on the upper. It requires a little bit experience, but believe me, this is how usually works in factories. They cut directly on that because they don't have too much time to transfer with silver pen and then cut. They cut right away, okay? So what is important here during cutting, you need to hold your upper firm so it will not move during cutting. And I advise to hold with your toes, fingers, close to the place where you cut. And she move along cutting with these fingers that you use as a press, to hold the upper. Now you see, I don't leave the cardboard pattern, it stay on the same place until I will cut entire upper. The knife must be sharp, and I also made the tutorial how to sharpen it. You can find the link to this tutorial below the video. Now don't leave the upper, the pattern, because now we need to transfer all important marks. We have here points of the center that we will transfer with the tip of awl. Here we also have mark of the center. This mark will help us to place our upper on the center of our shoe last. Now we have this mark. You remember I explained in the previous video that we need to have this mark to transfer this line, and we transfer it with silver pen. Now you will see that after I will take it off, this cardboard pattern, you will see that when I will assemble two parts, you will see that because of this approach, when we cut our marks a little bit behind the line, the original line, the edge of the silver pen will stay under this part that we will attach on top of this part. You see? And you remember this cut I made exactly on the line, so here this line maybe will be visible. Not maybe, it will be visible. Okay, now before you take it off from the pattern, from the leather, check well if you cut well. You see, in this place, for example, I didn't cut well, so I repeat this cut. It's not comfortable to cut like this sitting. It's better to cut when you will stand, because you can move around this place. But I need to show you like this, so you will see what I'm doing. Now this is our first part of the upper, and you see it, this mark, for example, that we have here, and I did this mark exactly on the original line of what we of the mark. You will see later then when I will attach it, all these lines will stay under the upper, the first part of the upper, and this one you will see, it will be visible. That's why I prefer to use this approach that I explained you in the previous lesson, in the previous part of this tutorial. Okay, this is how it's better to work when you make shoes professionally, because you don't need to waste so much time to erase all these lines. You have clean upper. Okay, so this we already cut. Now let's move on to the next part. Here also I don't check the stretchiness, because it doesn't involve me here in this example. And I try to find a place where I will waste less leather. Okay? Hold your cardboard pattern firm on the same place so it will not move. Let's check if I cut it through all edges. And now let's transfer all these important marks. This is the mark of the center, and according to this mark, we'll assemble this part and this part. Then comes these marks of the holes. Make with the tip of the awl holes through the marks that we have on the cardboard pattern. Okay, with the tip of the awl, we have here these holes, and we through these holes with the tip of the awl, we mark holes on the leather upper. Now silver pen, we transfer with the silver pen this mark where will be the seam. Okay, now let's move on. So this is how it will be, and we will start to assemble from this mark of the center. Later we will hit on this hole and we will erase it. Okay, actually it will be enough to make just small just touch with the awl the leather without using a pressure to not leave a big hole. I left here a little bit bigger hole than I need. When you will transfer the central marks of the center, just make this hole like this. Just touch with the awl leather and the mark from the awl will be visible. And according to this point, you will know how to assemble these two parts. Okay, now we will make here big holes. And then the small holes, two small holes between big holes, we will make them according to our eyes. Because we didn't mark here, and you can do it by eyes. It's enough to have big holes, so know where to place small holes of the perforation. So we start with the big holes. So place here puncher with big diameter, 4 millimeters, 3 millimeters, 3.5 millimeters. And then when you place the puncher, try to place the center of this puncher to this point, to this mark that we have here. So the center of the diameter will match the point, the mark that we have here on the leather. And as I told you before, to not ruin your cutting board, place some cardboard. If you see that you didn't cut with the puncher the hole, place it again on the same place and punch again. Here we have 2 points, 1 point mark. It's a mark to know how to assemble this part to the first part, and this mark, second one, this is our hole that we need to create here. Now I will demonstrate it, what I mean, the center. You see, the center of this mark left from the puncher lays exactly on the mark for the hole, okay? Now, between these holes, now we will make 2 holes using puncher with small diameter. We'll do it by eyes, and it will be in the middle of this area, 2 points like this, you see? And you can do it by eyes, you don't need to calculate here. If you want, you can do it, but it's better to do it on the pattern, but I don't prefer, because here will be too much holes. But it's actually doable. So it's one of the ways to mark these marks for the smaller holes also on the pattern, okay, if you want. But by eyes, it actually works fine. So let's change. Keep same distance by eyes to make these holes. I mean, distance between 2 holes, it's about 1.5 millimeters, 2 millimeters maximum. So this is what we got here. Between each 2 big holes, place 2 small holes by eyes. Now we have this mark for the seam, the second seam. The first seam is, if you remember, I told you in the previous part of this tutorial that we will mark it on leather, because the distance here from the edge is 1 millimeter. So I will mark this line using this instrument, but you can mark it with compasses with 2 pins. This is a perfect compasses to work with in pattern making. Instead of these gauges that I use here, you can use these compasses, and you can open the compasses in the distance that you want and close it, open it, and mark all needed marks on cardboard and on leather. I don't have it right now, because I started to work with these gauges, but this compasses is excellent tool for pattern making, and I will leave a link where you can find these compasses, okay? So now, using this instrument, the distance here is 1 millimeter, you will use the compasses. We need to mark line. It will scratch a little bit leather, but later we'll sew here and it will cover the scratch, because the stitch will be inside of this mark. Maybe it's hard for you to see this mark, but I can see it, and when I will sew, I will use it as a guideline to sew these 2 parts together. Now, this is first part. And before we'll attach it to our second part, we need to burn it. And that's why we need to have this lighter. We need to burn it because here we have some leftovers of leather. So to have clean leather without any leftovers of leather, we need to burn it. How to burn it? You need to move during this action. Don't stay too much time on one point because you'll burn your leather too much, okay? So like this. And forward and twice, it's enough. And also this edge. Okay, it's enough. Now this part has underline, but we will, and that means that we need to skive here, because if we will not skive here, we will have two thick edge that may extend through this one, and it will ruin the look of your upper, your shoes, and in some places if you will not skive it, you can feel this edge of leather, it will be not comfortable. So we need to skive it. Because here we have this perforation, we will skive it on the inner side of this upper. So we skive with the shoemaking knife, and to skive you need to place here your marble plate or glass plate and skive it. The distance of the edge that we need to skive is about 9 millimeters, because here we added this allowance, seam allowance, underline to the pattern, and that's why we need to skive it 9 millimeters. Okay, skive first edge, because later now we will hold it, hold here, so we will cover it, and that's why we need to skive first the edge and then skive like this entire edge. I already made tutorial about skiving, how to skive, so I will not spend now time to explain how to skive. You can watch this tutorial, and I will leave a link to this tutorial. Okay, so we skive the edge. You see it has smooth transition here, it's very thin here, and then it goes slowly and become with the original thickness where we will have the edge of this first upper. So that's why we will have a smooth transition between thin edge and thick edge, and you will not feel any extended edge under this part of our upper. Okay? So now we will need to attach these two parts together. So we will place glue here, but because we have here holes, and we don't want that the glue will can through this holes on the face side of the upper, we need to place glue a little bit here. And also a little bit glue here, just few points, so the glue will be not visible. And we will not need to work hard to clean the upper, okay? Now to place glue and protect your cutting board to not make it dirty with glue, place some paper, and now I will place here the contact glue for leather. So I will place here a little bit glue, don't exaggerate with the glue, because we don't want to see the glue coming through the holes. So in this kind of movements, you see, place a little bit of glue. Now here, because I have white leather, you know, I will prefer to place glue only on the edge, because it will be very visible, this glue on this kind of leather, white leather, and I will not wait 15 minutes until glue will dry, as we usually must do, because I want that this glue will also came to the this part to attach it better, because I didn't place here glue because of the color of this leather, and I know this white leather, it will be very difficult to clean from the spots, from the spots of the glue, and I don't want to do it, so that's why I'm placing this part, attaching it right now. So this glue, fresh glue, will be here, and then I will wait for 10-15 minutes until it will dry and they will be attached well together. So how we start? We start from these two points. We don't start from one edge or other edge. Why? Because during cutting, during skiving, you can deform the upper, the edges of your upper, and they, you can stretch them too much and change the original shape. So that's why to have precise uppers, especially both halves of your uppers, so they will be the same, you start always, no matter which type of footwear you're working on, you start from the center. And that's why it's very important to have these points on, these marks on your upper. So we start from the center. Place it in the way where these two holes marks match each other. Place. Now following this mark that we have, and you see in this place, not in this place, where it was, let's see to know how to attach it better. Yes, in this place, because I marked it on the original line, we can see a little bit the line. And here it must cover. Okay, hold like this and then hit with the hammer. Now I will need to wait until glue will dry, so it will not bother me when I will sew it. If you will work with different color of upper, not white, you should place also a little bit glue like I placed on this part. You need to place on this part glue like I placed on this part, okay? A little bit. Then wait 10-15 minutes until glue will dry, and then attach these two parts together, and then hit with the hammer. Okay? And now I will wait 10-15 minutes and I will go to sew. Okay, so now we will sew here. We have here two seams. This one and this one on the distance of 1 millimeter. You probably can't see this mark because it's too big distance between the camera and the upper, but I can see it, 1 millimeter. And I will sew here along this line, okay? So let's go to sew it. So right now we will sew following the marks that we have. I will start with the first seam, but it doesn't important. You can start from this one and then make the first one, okay? So the thread number is 60. It's polyester thread. Choose the color of thread that will suit the color of the upper. And we start from the stitching. I start from the stitching of first thread of first seam, following the marks that I left from the gauge in the distance of 1 millimeter. Now let's cut the ends of the thread. You saw that I didn't reinforce the beginning and end of each seam because these parts of our upper goes under shoe sole. We will last it, so we don't need to work here too hard to reinforce it. Just sew it and that's it. Then cut the edges of the thread. What we need to do right now is to hit a little bit with the hammer to flatten the seams and to close the holes left from the needle when we sew it. You see the difference? Right now it looks much better after we hit with the hammer. It's very important. It's a small detail, but it changed totally the look of your upper. Now, pay attention that you can't see here any marks of the silver pen. It's because of the approach that I use here. I only have the mark here and I need to erase it with this kind of material crap. I cut a thin piece to enter with the edge of this crap here and erase the line. If you have some spots of the glue, also erase with the crepe, but if you followed the exact steps of my explanation, you will not have any glue, any spots of the glue. Okay, now this is it. We finished this tutorial and you can see how beautifully it may look when this shoes will be finished. It's not real upper, yes. I only want to demonstrate it how it will look. Okay, and this is only simple example of possibilities that you have if you will implement this decorative element inside of your simple flat-bodied shoes, pump shoes, sandals, Oxford shoes, derby shoes, boots, whatever. It's suitable, this approach, design approach, pattern making approach is suitable everywhere in every footwear type. If you have questions about this tutorial, comment below the video and I will answer with the next one. Now, I also very interested to know where you're gonna use the perforation that I explained to you how to make it, in which footwear type. So comment below the video where you want to use this perforation. Second question that I have for you is about next tutorial. Previously I asked you about two tutorials about perforation and about another tutorial how to make the soft detail with the foam inside of sneakers. And most of you want to see this tutorial as well. So my question for you is, if you still want to see this tutorial, how to make this soft detail with stitches inside of sneakers or any other footwear type, please comment below the video. Okay, that's it. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. Thank you and see you in the next tutorial. Bye.